Well, we've told you about some of the things that are happening at the City Museum. Well, now Ruth Ezell brings us up to date on another favorite local attraction. If you haven't been there lately, you'll be finding some surprises this year when you walk in the front door.
I'm outside the St. Louis Science Center, and if you've been here recently, you know that you have to enter through the Explorer Dome on the western side of the complex. That's because the main entrance is closed due to a multi-year renovation project. I'll show you the latest in just a moment, but first, I want to take you back to last fall when renovations first got underway.
October 2003.
It's the very first thing that people are seeing as part of the campaign.
St. Louis Science Center Communications Director Bev Pfeiffer-Harms.
We're making a two-lane road that will funnel traffic from Oakland Avenue back to Berthold. It will help both the high school when the kids are coming to school, and it will help us during our busy times, especially on the weekend, to prevent the traffic buildups that we sometimes get on Oakland Avenue, all for safety.
What change is taking place right here when people walk in?
The lobby's going to look completely different. We have removed the aviation exhibits, and they're going into the flight gallery over in the underground tunnel. We are going to be completely changing what you see in here. Starting in the spring of 2004, you're going to see a wonderful ball machine in here where you get a chance to use physics and make balls go through all kinds of contortions and jumps and special effects right here in the gallery. It's going to be a showpiece, something that people in St. Louis talk about all the time. And then the really wonderful thing is that we're going to give you an opportunity to really enjoy our food service a whole lot more. We're going to be expanding it and bringing it out over our aviation gallery where you have a wonderful look of the ball machine. And so you're going to get better eating, better reception, more fun. It's going to be a great new lobby.
The tunnel connecting the Science Center and the Planetarium is undergoing changes too.
The tunnel will be completely devoted to all of the XPRIZE teams. There are a lot of different types of vehicles that are being designed to go up into space. A lot of different physics going on, a lot of different science going on. And so each one of the panels will explain the science behind that particular team and how they're making their ship go up in the air.
Well, it's mid-March now. We're above the lobby of the Science Center, and it's been gutted. Even the escalator, it used to be right over there, it's been taken out. The question is, will the escalator be replaced?
No, we decided that the escalator encouraged a lot of behavior that was a little bit too extreme. So we decided to go with a grand sweeping staircase. We're going to have a new elevator, a larger and faster elevator, so that's going to be much more to our advantage than the escalator was. And this also allows us to free up a lot more space in the lobby, space for our food service, space for people just to get acclimated to the place and decide what to do. It's going to look a lot nicer, too, a lot cleaner and crisper.
Are you happy with the way the entrance turned out?
It really fits with the whole campus feel that we're establishing. St. Louis University High School is a wonderful partner in this. They've committed to staying in St. Louis, and they're about turning the area behind them more into a green space and athletic fields and campus. So it's going to have a nice benefit for us on the side as well.
Fly me to the moon. Let me play among the stars. Let me see what spring is like on Jupiter and Mars.
The new flight gallery includes memorabilia you may remember or might have even owned, depending on your age.
In other words,
the XPRIZE exhibit includes models from the contenders. Each of the competing teams hope to take a privately built spacecraft with a crew of three up to the boundaries of space, come back safely, then do it again within 3 weeks.
Well, the XPRIZE program is based in St. Louis. We've been involved with them since the beginning on the development of the organization. And we are going to serve as mission control when the first flights come up. So it'll be kind of exciting for us.
And if you've ever seen a movie at the Omnimax Theater, you may notice the improvements there, too.
We needed new seats and new carpet, so we took the opportunity to replace those, and that turned out very nicely. We changed the lighting to a computerized color blending lighting system in our cove, which really looks nice. We went to digital sound. the platters that we're showing here are able to hold about 45 to 50 minutes of IMAX film, which means back before we made these technical improvements, we were limited to about a 45 or 50 minute film at one setting. Well, one of the things we wanted to do was to capitalize on a change that's taking place in the market, and that is that a lot of the commercial films that are being released are also now being made in the IMAX format. And so, in order to show, let's say, the Harry Potter film that's coming out this summer, we wanted to be able to change the platters to show a continuous film. So that's what we've done here. 10 years ago, a computer the size of a desktop computer was running a system like this. Now it's a Palm Pilot that's running a system like this.
When this is all complete, would you say this will be the premier science center in America?
Well, of course I'm biased, but yeah, I'd say that we're going to cover a lot of bases very well, and our particular focuses, particularly aviation and flight, is something that we really have carved a niche out in. Air and Space Museum in Washington may have it on us as far as artifacts and interpretation, but we are able to offer here in the Midwest pretty close to an air and space experience.